मोशन, इसके लिए वी नीड ए रेफरेंस पॉइंट नंबर वन. सो हाउ व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेस्ट? एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज सेड टू बी एट रेस्ट इफ इट डज नॉट चेंज इट्स पोजीशन विद रेस्पेक्ट टू इट्स सराउंडिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू आर सिटिंग इन ए रनिंग ट्रेन. You are sitting in a running train and your co-passenger is also with you and one person is standing on the platform. Now train is running. So if suppose this is Arnav and this is your friend and this is the your father is standing at the platform. Now for Arnav, this is your reference point and your friend is sitting near to you, so this surrounding become your train. So inside the train, if you watching each other, so both of you are in rest. But a person is standing outside the train, if he looks you, both of you, you and your friend, both are in motion. So we can say to define an object is rest and motion, we need its reference point or surrounding. Then definition is in on screen also. An object is said to be at rest if it does not change its position with respect to its surrounding with passes time. Now examples: a person, a chair, a person sitting on a bench, your chair, table, etc. This is your rest. And now we come to the next term, motion. So how you can define motion? Okay, the object is said to be in motion when it changes its position with respect to its surrounding. But in the case of rest, position of the object does not change. But in the case of motion, the position of the object must continuously change with passes time. Okay, so example: fan, motion of a plane, motion of a car, etc. And these two terms, motion and rest, are relative terms. If an object is in one situation, it is in rest, and the same time it may be in motion. That I explain you with this example. कि योर फ्रेंड सिटिंग विद बिकम योर को पैसेंजर इन द ट्रेन. सो दैट फ्रेंड इज इन रेस्ट पोजिशन बट योर फादर और पर्सन इज स्टैंडिंग आउटसाइड द ट्रेन, इट इज इन मोशन. सो दीज टू टर्म्स आर को रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर. ओके, सो दिस इज द रिलेटिव टर्म्स. आई गिव यू, यू कैन रीड दिस स्लाइड. के पैसेंजर सिटिंग इन ए मूविंग ट्रेन इज एट रेस्ट विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू दिस फेलो पैसेंजर, but it is in motion with respect to person outside the train. Thus, you can say these two terms are correlated to each other. So, any doubt up to here, rest and motion? I hope it is clear to everyone.
Yes.
Okay. Now, we come to the next. Types of motions according to the directions or dimensions. It says three types of motion. Up to your level, one dimensional motion, two dimensional motion and three dimensional motion. If a person moving along a straight line only in one direction, is not in the two direction, only in one direction, then we can say the motion of the person or train or object is in the one dimensional motion. Okay. So the car on the track, train on the track, these are the example of the one dimensional motion. And two dimensional motion, you can say if a body moving along the two direction, x axis along y axis, it may be along y and z axis, then motion is said to be two dimensional motion. For example, motion of the fan. It is a circular motion is another term we will discuss in the next topic. But here our aim is to the key, it is one dimensional, two dimensional or three dimensional. So it move along two axis, circular motion along x or y. So we, it is a two dimensional motion. And then third term is three dimensional motion, motion of a plane. Plane can move along x direction also, y also, z. It can move upward side also, it can move downward side also. So its motion is called three dimensional motion. So you can see this screen also one dimensional motion. I have mentioned the definition. If the motion of an object is said to be one dimensional, if only one of the three considering changes here, object moving along a straight line. Example, same motion of the train moving along a straight line. Motion of a freely falling body. It's also a one dimensional motion. If you drop a ball from your roof, then it goes downward direction. This just like a pen. I fall it in the downward direction. It is a one dimensional motion. But if you throw a stone or any object, make some angle with you like that, then it is a two dimensional motion. And motion and trajectory of this particle becomes parabolic. It's not a straight line. In this situation, if you throw a particle, make some angle with horizontal, then it's two direction, along x and along this. Due to gravitational force, it's fall down. So it is a two dimensional motion. But if you straightly drop a object from here to here, then this motion is your one dimensional motion. It's clear? Any doubt?
Yes.
One dimensional and two dimensional?
No.
Motion of a plane? Three dimensional. Motion of the kite flying in the sky? It's three dimensional. Motion of the smoke? It's three dimensional motion. I hope this is clear to both, all of you. One dimensional motion, two dimensional motion, and three dimensional motion. Any doubt? Anybody have any doubt? Okay, so now we come to the next one. Any doubt? So next term is distance, displacement. We will discuss now these another two terms, distance and displacement. Can you tell me what you understand by the term distance? Anybody? My aim is to define now term distance. And another term is displacement. One term is distance, another term is displacement. Yes, distance and displacement. Then
the actual path of length traveled by a moving object or a
body. How we can define distance? Say, for example, a person moving from the place A and it will move at the place B. The length of between this A and B, length, I am using the term length, not distance, say 10 kilometer. Right? Now at 10 am you start your motion from A, after some time you reach at the point B. So what is the actual length of the path covered by a person is known as distance. This can be understood by another example. Say like that. Start from A, reaches at B along a straight line. Now I then B to C like that. This is in one direction, then this is in another direction. B reaches here, B to C, then A to C. This is your 10 kilometer.